What's up, y'all? This is Tabi Bonney. Right about now, you're tuned into PATisDOPE.com, the one-on-one interview with me, Tabi Bonney.
I'm here with Tabi Bonney, DMV Zone, one-on-one PATisDOPE.com exclusive interview. Tabi, we talked a lot about the pocket and the way things progress. Talk a little bit about your upbringing. A lot of people say you come from, quote-unquote, money, and that kind of bothers me because it takes away from all the work that you put in, all the grind that you put in. Just explain the process of how things progress over time.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we don't come from money. I mean, my people just make it look good. Just, you know, middle class, humble upbringings and whatnot. I never got any handouts. My people never gave me stuff to say, hey, here you go. You know what I mean? Man, just, you know, grinding myself, just use whatever little bit of money that I had. And that's one thing, I just always invested in myself, you know? So just put like every bit of money that I had into stuff, whether it be posters, to get my CDs pressed up, to paying someone to shoot my own video, and that was it. So I actually put all my money in to the point that I would be broke because I put all my money into this, you know what I mean?
Yeah. All right, talk about, let's not talk about too much of the label situation. Talk about touring. You just said you was in Beijing. You got a lot of love in New Mexico, Chicago. What about DMV love?
You know, this is where we're from, so people are used to just say, you know, just seeing you on the street is nothing to say as special. You know what I mean? Because they're like, oh, you know, that's just Tabi from, say, around the way and stuff like that. And I think we have a hard time with, you know, appreciating our own. Until it's like, you know, it's past the point where it's like, you know, it's just no denying it. Then it's like everybody wants to, you know, pretty much all the way hop on your nuts. You know what I mean? So that's how DC is, though. You know, we're just too cool, and you know, it's no fault of our own. It's just the way we were raised. You know.
All right, let's talk Twitter. I know you're active on Twitter.
Yeah.
What's the worst comment or tweet you have ever seen since you've been on there? Like, just the worst hate message you ever seen?
I don't know per se. I mean, I get it, but I mean, it, you know, stuff like that doesn't bother me at all. Like, most of the times I realize that most of the people that have hateful things to say are people that aren't doing nothing at all and unsuccessful and frustrated with their own lives. So that's just how I see it. So it doesn't really bother me. If anything else, it's just motivation, because there's some truth in everything. You know what I mean? So you just look at it and be like, okay, that's what they think. Then, you know what I mean? Let me check into that or look at this. Or, you know, nah, maybe they're just totally wrong, you know?
All right, let's talk fashion and females.
Okay.
So as far as fashion, like what you wearing nowadays, and what's up with the Bonnie wrong with that?
What am I wearing right now? I just started going back to the thrift stores and stuff, man. Because I got tired of, you know, kind of the regular urban wear and stuff like that. I just like to switch my style up every couple of years. So back in the thrift store, still high-end stuff. I still do the, you know, the Neiman Marcus and stuff like that. And even when I travel different places, stuff, you know, people have never heard of.
Yeah.
The clothing line, that's the infrastructure. I just had to get the infrastructure right, because every time I would put it out, I never would be able to keep up with the demand of it.
Okay.
So I just got tired of having it, you know what I mean, just being sold out and can't supply as much as, you know what I mean, as much to the people. So I just wanted to get it right. Got my cousin on board, who's from London, so it'll be financed properly this time. And then actually we have to take a trip, so I think we're going to like Vietnam to check out the factories out there. And then this go around, it's going to be just we're going to do jeans with shirts and everything. So I'm probably looking at like next summer officially to, like, you know what I mean, like a soft real launch of the clothing line.
So let's talk females. I guess let me say females worldwide, TV, social media, who you feeling right now? Like, if you had a chance to talk to one female, who would you try to, you know what I'm saying, reach out to?
Man, I don't know if it would be anybody, say, per se, who's famous, even though I remember, you know, meeting and seeing, say, Rihanna and Cassie in person, and they're just, you know, at the time when I saw them, they were flawless. I don't know if it was makeup or anything else, but they just look like butter. You know what I mean?
I don't know about Rihanna, but probably Cassie. I mean, Rihanna is like a hit and miss with me. You know?
Gotcha.
All right, so what's next for you? I know you're having shooting a video this weekend.
Yeah, shooting two videos, just trying to knock out as much stuff as possible. So I'm about to go on tour for 2 months. We got 51 cities. It's backed by Dame Dash. I'm on the road with Merz. Mm-hmm. Sponsored by Adidas and MTV, so that's a good thing. And I'm just trying to work as much right now just because it's harder for me when I'm on the move to like create and knock out videos and stuff. So while I'm stable right now, I'm just trying to knock out like almost a video every week right now. Just so stuff can keep on going while I'm out and gone, you know?
Yeah. So I asked you about DMV rappers, and of course the biggest name in the DMV is probably Fat Trail.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? Of course Fulani has been holding his weight. So I mean, what do you feel like Fat Trail can take it mainstream?
Yeah, I definitely think so.
Leave the situation?
Yeah, I definitely think so. It's no denying what just an organic buzz. You know what I mean? Like the people just genuinely like it's no denying them. It's music, it's feel, it's just you just get it. You know what I mean? So you know, I even told him, I was like, man, as long as you just keep going, you got it. As long as you don't mess up anywhere else, you know, as far as like your personal life and the streets and stuff like that, he's good. He'll be out of here.
All right. My last two questions is, of course, we're going to go back to this. What's up with, are you still in contact with Wale and how things changed since Pocket and all that?
Yeah.
Is that still your homeboy?
Yeah, we're cool. I mean, you know, he's, of course, dumb busy right now. You know what I mean? So we're cool. Text each other every now and then. I'll see him like sliding through the street, and he'll hit me with a text saying, "I see you on a date right now." So we know we joke a lot. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, no, I mean that's the homie, man. It's just so much. You know, it's just great to just see someone out of the city just take it to that next level. Yeah. And what people don't understand is that it helps everybody. It opens up opportunities for everybody. So I don't see how people could, you know, be mad at a person or, you know what I mean? Like have hate for anybody trying to do something or make it out of the city. Because prior to him or me, there was not, you know what I mean? There wasn't, but you know, of course you got the nonchalance and people like that before us, but yeah. I mean, to take it to that next level, there hasn't been anybody. So and what people got to realize, it opens up a whole new industry, economy, everything for DC, you know what I mean? So, you know, that's the homie, man. Like everything's still cool. All
right, last question. Your thoughts on Watch the Throne? Everything about it, the video, Jay, Kanye, the lyrics, and just what's your personal feeling?
It just looks like they're having fun right now. They're doing it because they can do it. They're recording whatever, you know, I think that they want to record or feel or whatever messages that they want to put out. And I like it, man. You know what I mean? A lot of people have, you know, say different things and stuff to say about it or have certain expectations about it. But it's surely just art and music and their perspective on life right now. You know what I mean? So I love the video. It shows them having fun and not mean mugging or anything. It's like, you know, they actually put it out like, yeah, we're a group. I'm not Jay-Z, I'm not Kanye. It's like, you know, we are a group, we're friends, we're buddies. This is it.
You can say whatever you want to say, end it off.
Man, just, you know, make sure you live your life, do your own thing. Don't worry about whatever else anybody else is doing, man. Just get out there and live your dreams, because I'm definitely living mine.